Came out here to the barn to play with some scrapbooks. Whenever postcards and whatnot arrive, I put them up on a string that goes between kind of our living room and our kitchen room. And every once in a while, the string fills up and I get the glorious pleasure of archiving these. So I have a stack here of postcards and cards. I also have a pile of artifacts and things from a trip to Shimane, where we went to a museum and an aquarium and whatnot. I've kind of made the scrapbook for this, but there's a few pages that still need filled out, plus some narrative, and I got this stamp that does dates on it, and so I want to put some dates on the pages, just, you know, because I can. And then I have this pile that's some more, you know, there's postcards and cards and letters, and then there is kind of dossiers where people send me like magnificent assortments of things like stamps and union cards and CDs and brochures and whatnot. So that's kind of a separate pile I have going. But my desk was shockingly tidy because yesterday, Darlene wife and I had this flipped upside down because we were putting some boards on the bottom to put casters on it. Because this space, while it's perfect, it's ideal if it's kind of multifunctional, which means the easel's on casters, this workbench, well, this equipment totes that mostly holds electronic doodads is on casters that we installed. So we're putting casters on this. So I have no drawers in here right now, and all my supplies are over here, but, you know, you get a notion to do something and you might as well do it. So first thing I need is a empty scrapbook for these postcards. And recently I picked up a batch of these ones and I love them because they're this accordion style. I gotta be careful because some things aren't glued down. Oopsie, there we go. They work out great. So an example is, this is a previous one. This is festive time. So this is Christmas and New Year's cards. Not the huge variety of New Year's cards that we get in Japan, the Nengajo, but for the most part, international Christmas cards. And sometimes the cards are a little bit big, so then I have to do some tricky modifications, which we might do today to kind of fit this in. The form factor on this is a little bit smaller than this. So I found these ones recently, and they're a great size, and they have a little leather-esque binding on them. And I have some over here. Okay. So, interior of this one is kind of a chocolate brown, a milk chocolate brown, and this one is black inside. I think in this case, I think we're gonna use the chocolate brown kind of one. And of course, it's this kind of accordion shape, so you can fill both sides, and then it gets, the whole thing gets to be quite thick and chubby. Like me. Ooh, this one already has some dried flowers in it. So I suppose this is waiting for us. So, got a record on, incense burning. Now for the most part, I put these in, if there's nothing significant on the back, I'll stick them directly. Sometimes there's a little bit of a narrative or information about the artist of the card, so I like to keep that. In the case of like this, where there's message on the back, you know, definitely that doesn't get glued down. So I have a pile of envelopes that I then make into envelopes to then slide the card into. So the envelope gets cut, tacked in, or sometimes I make a hinge, and then eventually all of these get replied to and whatnot. Should we go through a few and see what we got? Let's start off with this one. This is a correspondent who I haven't met in real life who does a series of postcards about Richard Brautigan, the great American writer, Montana/Tokyo/California writer, and a lovely note on the back, so this one I'll definitely be replying to. And, well, I did reply to her first one, but there's actually two from this correspondent on the same theme. So Richard Brodigan. This next one is from a lady who's a photographer who does these great photographs of hummingbirds, as well as makes wonderful stamps. She's in Vancouver, and a lovely handmade card with her photo on the front, a photo she took. And then here is some friends in, formerly of Seattle, now of California, in the California desert. Another lovely one. And there's a nice snail mail stamp on the back, and it's a hand-drawn, hand-watercolored piece of art on the front. Another treasure. I always talk about this train trip I did 10 years ago. It's Tracks on Tracks, Vancouver to Toronto, 11 rock and roll bands, a documentary film crew, CBC Radio 3, and me as your Svengali-like advisor slash a suitcase, Hunter Thompson meets Bob Marley suitcase, until it was a phenomenal trip. At the end was the North by Northeast Festival in Toronto, music and technology and art, which I did a keynote. There's a secret message here that says something about there might be something more to say. Tracks on Tracks. If you're curious, podcasts and video clips and whatnot at the usual place. All right, what else? Oh, wonderful lady with a handmade block print here. I mean, I get the best stuff. And again, a friend I haven't met in real life, but she saw that I was having a rough time of it. Like, this year has been tough. I'm not here to dwell on that, but it's so nice when people notice that and send me cards. They are treasures, and they'll be treasures forever. This is a musician in California who is a fantastic designer, been a longtime correspondent, again, never met in real life, which is kind of odd, but remixed my own kind of style with the inspected stamp. I don't have one that says inspected, and some sort of like mathematical eye test bingo card looking art, and tickets, and but again, the back is all decorated, so I don't want to put glue that directly on. This is a friend who, a frequent correspondent, who I do know in real life, and again, noticed I was having a bit of a hard go of it, and gave me some lovely advice, including advice about parenting, and, you know, with our little Ichiro, he's in that preschool phase where they seem to come home with colds all the time, so she gave me a little, some friendly words about that. This one came from Woodstock, New York, from a publisher, writer, artist who has a bookshop in Woodstock and spends a lot of time in India and Nepal, two countries which I quite adore. And again, remixing my same themes with the big stamps, confidential. It's nice to know I'm not the only one who's doing that all the way from Woodstock. And again, supporting independent booksellers. Do I need to even remind you? All right. Now, this is art from the child of a friend, a correspondent here in Japan, who, again, I haven't met in real life, but shares an interest in pickling, fermenting, putting produce into jars in various ways. And as a way of swinging back the inspiration, sent me this card made by his daughter, I think. I should have prepared. Now, Moab, speaking of place dear to my heart, Moab, Utah. And this is one of my longest time dear friends, and her daughter recently got married, and I guess that, and her son went away to university in Montana, so I guess that makes them empty nesters, as they say. They have a bread baking business in Idaho. They made a trip to Moab, Utah, and we visited there on several occasions together, and I tell you, I hear about lineups and cars and commotion trying to get into this park, but there's few more majestic views you'll ever see in the world than delicate arch in the right light. Gosh, I love this graphic design too. Great graphic design again. This is a friend who I actually coincidentally saw on an airplane coming back from Japan some years ago. and she ordered a batch of my art cards and sent me this great view of Gastown. And this is the Hotel Europe, and I used to work at an office right here and could look into this. I always thought this would be such a cool apartment to live in. And mentions in here about places in Gastown, Nelson the Seagull, and yeah, these little places that bring back some flashbacks in Gastown, which used to be kind of my stomping grounds. And recently, Chairman Ting, the artist, doing Billions of Buns NFT project. Anyway, Chairman Ting, a Vancouver renegade artist, asked me in response to something about fireworks on the Twitters, do I miss Vancouver? And I thought a lot about that. And there's moments I miss and little snippets I miss. Riding the sea bus, wandering around Gastown in the rain, coffee shops, and Stanley Park sometimes. But what I don't miss is the difficulty of housing and the social and political conundrums, transportation conundrums, which continue to plague the conversation. And now I see it from a distance and I say, gosh, Vancouver, so much potential. You're right there. But, you know, it's not my circus, not my place. I poured my heart into Vancouver for sure and have wonderful memories. But now that time is over and now I live here. Did I show this already? So this is a mixed media, multimedia artist and dear friend in Austin, Texas, which seems to attract a phenomenal assortment of people. Again, do I miss Austin? You know, I used to go to South by Southwest every year and I had fantastic experiences there. Certainly did a couple keynotes, a couple panels, felt like a big shot, so many restaurants and bars and all the like. She's a remarkable lady, and her card came at the beginning of the year after I talked about starting the year off on such a wrong foot. So she reminded me of the warmth and positivity I send out to the world, the endless inspiration, and the reminder to do less and to take it easy, which I hope you will do as well. We are good mirrors for each other. As soon as I start feeling better, I tend to overdo it. I read this so many times. There's so much, always so much to be done. I read this so many times in January, where I spent most of the month in bed, and since then, there also came with a couple little pieces of art which sit on my desk in the front room. You know, I have at least three desks scattered throughout the compound, and the collage, the inky pen, the sparkly tape, all of it radiates her kindness, for which I'm so grateful. This one I'm not gonna show you because it's a family picture, but this card made the 5,682 mile journey from the Netherlands to here. A wonderful package from a sweetest, toughest, how do you say it? He's a very strong man and a very sweet man. Lives in Amsterdam with his beautiful family, two kids. And when Ichiro was born, like just as soon as we arrived home, there was a big box waiting for them with all kinds of handy little things, which we had a hard time preparing for Ichiro's coming because of the logistics of going out and shopping. And just recently there was another package, including some Stroop waffles. Like, I'm already a little bit chubby, right? So I've been very cautious with those. But more toys for Ichiro, and Ichi loves playing outside with the rakes and shovels and sand and stuff, because, you know, he reflects the grandparents and who are always working in the yard. So a lovely card from Amsterdam. This comes from someone who shared so many adventures with on Galliano / Hornby Island, and brought back some wonderful memories of his visit to Japan for our wedding. And he's looking forward to return to Japan. And that's a whole topic. You know, every time the window opens a tiny little bit, there's people asking me for the details. Oh, we're coming to visit. Yeah, I want everyone to come visit. Hold on, switching the record. Logistics change on the regular. And right now, like for as of today in early June, there's some limited tour-sponsored groups who are accepting liability and responsibility for the patrons of vaccinated and tested people coming to Japan with masks in most, if not all, circumstances. But this isn't Dave can hang up a shingle and be a tour guide. This is some corporate entity tour companies and on a designated route. And so, you know, it's just not happening. It'll happen eventually, right? And when the time comes, great. But it turns out travel and the crossing between borders isn't some inherent human right. Countries have different ways of approaching things. Duh. Like, we've learned that, right? Haven't we? Have we learned things? Here's from Newfoundland, the very easternmost part of Canada, which wasn't a part of Canada until the 1950s. And I was having a conversation with someone recently about the logistics of countries in the Commonwealth who still have the monarchy of the United Kingdom as its head of state, in this case Queen Elizabeth II, the person known as, and the logistics of changing the currency, the bills, the coins, the postage stamps, the commemorative photos in hockey rinks and schools and government buildings, and how they went through this with King Ed VIII, who abdicated after a short tenure. Maybe you know this story. So it went from George to Ed to Elizabeth, all in about 18 months, 2 years. So there was a lot of logistics of just changing portraits and changing these things, as well as all the pomp and circumstance of naming schools and roads and other stuff that goes along with that. So, you know, there's conversations in Australia and other places, I guess it was Bermuda, Barbados, oh geez, I should have known this, that just made themselves a republic, removing the queen as the head of state or the subsequent kings that may come afterwards. And the question comes up about, and oh, I mentioned this because Newfoundland, at the time, wasn't part of Canada, so they had to change all their stamps and currencies as well. And I have a few of those things here in my elegantly organized flat file. But at some point, there's going to be a change. And these Commonwealth countries who have the UK monarchy arbitrarily as a head of state will have to decide, do we change all of this stuff? And do we want to see Charles's face on everything? Coming from someone who attended Prince Charles Elementary School in Surrey, British Columbia. Jeez. Anyway, Rebbe was on the Tracks and Tracks trip and was such a dear friend to me when I really needed a friend in Newfoundland, visiting St. John's when I was looking for a home. And I got to see some icebergs and go to the very, on that trip I went from the very westernmost points, southwestern points of Canada to the very northeastern points of Canada, looking for a home, which I did not find in Canada. And here I am in Japan. Here's a Valentine's Day card and a get well soon. And I mean, this is tough because people ask me how I am and to get well soon. And this was, I've talked about this previously, so I won't dwell on it here. It's a train. The track keeps on going and going around like a loop. There's not a beginning, middle, and end to this journey. Happy Valentine's Day. Thank you very much for that. Here is a friend who, again, saw us having a hard time and just, you know, sometimes I get feeling blue and I reach out into the world. Hello, I'm still here. I'm still here, Vancouver, Victoria, Utah, wherever other places I've lived. Like, you know, I have a wonderful life here, but I just love being part of people's lives. And this friend noticed this and shared with me some of her experience working in immigration and just how you move away and support circles and circumstances change, circumstances change for you, but and the support circles as such change, and people kind of forget there's a whole big weird world out there. As my buddy Dane, from whom I stole this Black Angels shirt, would tease me about, like, I'm living in random Asia, and there's this amorphous blob of places that are not where you live, and it turns out they're very distinct from one another. And last year was a wedding announcement, but it was beautifully produced. I'm not going to show you the photo, but it was beautifully produced, but it has these photo corner edges that I love, which I will be using today, because I have a whole box full of them here, different tapes and photo corner edges. And then last, I was in Kyoto for an event about acquiring, renovating, community building around classic Japan farmhouses, and I went to the Gion Kyoto post office, mailed myself a postcard so I could get their franking mark, but unfortunately they didn't really do a great one. But I wanted to send this card of a postbox with a postbox stamp from a post office that I have. I took a picture of me in front of the post office to make a completely recursive project. Now, I also went to Ginkakoji Temple, and they did a lovely franking stamp, franking cancellation stamp on this postcard. So it's a picture of the temple with a stamp of the temple with a cancellation stamp with the temple. Meta. So that's what I'm going to work on. So you're welcome to just hang out and listen to the records. This is Aztec Camera from 1982-3, album called Knife, the Japanese pressing packaging, and just arrived the other day. And it's lyrically quite wonderful and has that warm analog sound. And from a technical note, I've added a preamp to my turntable in between the turntable and the amplifier. Still not convinced it's the right choice. The form factor was nice. Just not sure. I'm not very good at the technical bits and pieces, right? And I'm also filming this on two cameras because I'm trying to figure out how to work this Canon camera and using the iPad in case that doesn't work out. So I really don't know what I'm doing, which I suppose is mostly always the case. So, and also I should say this Golden Girls card reminds me of a friend in Utah who I hope is doing great. She loves this program. So I'm gonna start this one off with the card from Kim because that arrived right at the beginning of the year. And usually on the front of the books too, I'll add some kind of talisman, some piece of artifact to kind of give it a little bit of a title page. Like you can see with these scrapbooks, they have aerogram covers and some stickers. So we'll get to that eventually. So I think what I'm going to do with this one is I'm going to put a hinge on it rather than an envelope because it's quite a large card. And so it actually builds it into being part of the book itself. Reinforcing there, and let's put another strip here. I mean, I have a load of tape and pens and whatnot, but I only have a little subset here on the table because sometimes you just have to work. Oh, actually, let's use this one. You guys just got to work with what you got in your hand and kind of create creativity through constraints. When you have an endless assortment of things, it can paralyze you for choice, and lead to just not getting anything done. So this was picked up at Tokyo Hands in Kyoto. Some new tape. Always putting in that first one. Breaking the back on the project, as my mom would say, is a bit of a step because it means that, you know, for the last several days I've been thinking about, ooh, this will be a nice little project. And The hockey game score was had gotten uninteresting. I got the laundry in and the dishes done, as I usually do. That's for you, Ted. And today was a day to come out and have a little bit of a chance. Doko is in Karaski on a job site doing a planning project for a garden. And Ichiro is at preschool. So there we go. All right, so I try to put in some of the big, kind of the big pieces to kind of anchor it and make some hay of getting this underway. So let's go the same kind of theme again, but I'm going to use this tape because these purples and browns kind of pick up the same colors as her lovely card. Sometimes this kind of tape is called washi tape, but washi is just a word for paper, kind of specifically handmade paper. So it's just kind of paper tape, but it's sort of decorative, semi-translucent masking kind of tape made specifically for crafts. I have one more color here. Oh, here we go. Force it a little bit there. Same idea here. Now this one doesn't have much of a back of significance, so I'm gonna use my beloved double-sided tape, of which I have several widths and weights and qualities of, and put this one directly down onto the substrate, as it were. Sometimes it just doesn't need any decoration, just perfect the way it is. Now this one, has a bit of a missive on the back about the artist who made this. So, let's make a little mount for it that still shares the front. So I'm going to take one of these rice paper envelopes that I used to get at the Japanese 100 yen stores years ago, my first time around Japan, have used forever. I still have a stash because, like, I came home with stash in the early 90s and it ended up in a storage locker. And now it has repatriated itself. And these were also used for a corporate promotional concept I did, which some of you may be familiar with, the original ones. Okay, so a little pinking shears, a little slice down the side. And it'll snuggle in like this. And so it can be easily removed. You know what I could do is do this like here. What I'll do is I'll put it in reverse so that way it's a little bit more safe and secure in the folio. A couple pieces of this double-sided tape, which my pal Trevor on Pender Island will recall the usefulness of in the flower stick days. It reminds me, I've been meaning to write a note to Colin, who taught us that skill and also was there for a conversation again another time where I really needed a friend. So it just sort of nestles in like that, easy to pull out at your leisure. Nothing fancy. And I could have, of course, made that taller, but it kind of, I like it kind of peeking out, and this isn't some sort of secure thing. It just has to be in there, right? And just for fun, let's put a photo corner up on this top side to kind of keep it a little bit more snug. And a little bit of, and it picks up that metallic flare on the bug here in the picture. Yeah! This album somehow is appropriate. It's got a stamp on it. Discarded. Discarded stamp. If you have records you wish to discard, please consider them sending them to me instead. Okay. All right, let's do this with the octopus print and the card that goes with it. And this is gonna go in with photo corners because this is a signed and numbered hand-printed octopus, which may, you know, in a case like this, oftentimes this would, I would frame and display this elsewhere, but it just fits so well into this scrapbook. And I have the photo corners, so this will be a treasured home for it. Thank you. All right. The two I sent to myself from Kyoto are going to go in a different pile in a different circumstance, assembled with other items from Kyoto. Go together, and I think Rebbe and Tracks on Tracks will go together. Although stylistically they look different, but they remind me of each other. Then this flower and Woodstock will go together. Gastown and Golden Girls, and then this Richard Brodigan has a friend. So let's next do Arches. Which temps are perfect, 72 degrees, a few clouds, saw tons of impressive petroglyphs, ate burritos, and got sunburned. Bought his own copy of Desert Solitaire from the bookstore on Main Street. Back of Beyond Books, which is currently for sale. So if anyone has a notion to be a bookshop owner in a quirky town, and all the adventures that come with that, Back of Beyond Books in Moab is capital L legendary. And my understanding is it is for sale. Wouldn't that be a dream? Okay, now this has gotten a little bit tattered and battered. So I think I'm gonna put that in a little, let's make an envelope for this. Their little photo corners here have gotten damaged, so I'm going to replace one of them actually with a slightly different color, so we'll know that this is a replacement. It's my own sort of kintsugi, repairing things with gold. Thank you. And I love invitation cards and wedding invitation cards or whatever you have. Even if I'm not able to attend these events because I live far away and it's not logistically possible, if you know you're getting married, you're doing something like that, please do send me a card. At least you know someone will archive this for the historical record and enjoy the nuance and details of it. That makes quite a nice spread. And this is generational, because this is a mother and daughter both sending beautiful correspondence. Am I the luckiest dude? Okay, I'm going to go away from my original idea from putting Rebbe and Tracks on Tracks together, because this, you know, the train one and the block print style here of Gastown, these, I don't know, sometimes you just have to play your hunch, right? So this is going to go with these. I put black corners on this. Now, this could also, because I overthink everything, because Tracks on Tracks has its own dossier and own other ephemera collection, this could go into a different category. But if for some reason I need to make a diorama or a shadow box of all the associated things, I can do that. And I also have a print of this same artwork, a larger print, probably in here in the drawer that says art, signed by all the bands that were on the trip. As well as one of my static montage collage storyboards, like the Palau one you see behind me, next to all the hats, of Tracks on Tracks trip. Okay, so this Gastown one, I see this sort of peachy pink color, and so let's see if I have something that picks up that color. And sure enough. Oh, Vancouver.
This is a great school. I don't care what anybody says. I mean, it's not perfect, but like the people are really cool. Like the teachers, the kids, they really care. And I know they make fun of New Jersey all the time. I don't care, because they're just snobs. Because you just want me out, because
I don't know what movie this is from, but this is Belle and Sebastian doing the soundtrack to some movie. All right. So, makes a nice little spread here of kind of block print, and they kind of mirror each other a little bit. And a lot of these envelopes that the cards and letters come in, I'm keeping them because they're going to get shredded up and then made into washi handmade paper sometime in a future craft project. So I'm keeping old paper. Like, I suppose that's hardly shocking. This one, let's put blue photo corners on the top and green on the bottom, so it'll kind of tie into the artwork. Start on this side, but these accordion books are great because you have a whole other blank slate side to work with, so you can fit in a remarkable amount of stuff in here. Thank you. So that's Newfoundland with blue photo corners to match the icebergs. Now we come to this one that has a Nepal, India vibe going on. And I think I'm going to use the same envelope I did before. This is Year of the Pig, which is 2 years ago now, because it was pig, rat, now it's tiger. Canucks envelopes to use. I have this handmade rough one and some other handmade papers. So I think I'm going to pause and regroup and tidy up. This one, it has a companion piece, and I want to see that one before I put it in so it fits together. So I'm going to finish for today by putting in this Happy Valentine's Day, Get Well Soon, and that's going to get blue corn. Well, we've used the blue a lot. Not that it matters. So I'm going to use the lavender. I'm going to put that in, and then I'm going to go take a little break and make a tea. Come back and put a few more things in the trip to Shimane, including figuring out how this stamp works. Because this stamp, it has a cute little frilly border on it, decorative border on it, and a changeable date, and then also a slot that has, how do you call it, like a little weather report or a little iconography to say sunny, cloudy, rainy. There's something with a car, something with a camera, something okay. So I haven't actually used this stamp yet, so I want to try that out. I won't use it in this book because just doesn't really need it. Maybe on the front cover. So anyway, let's finish with that for now. The record's over, so nice timing. And, well, we'll see how it all ends up. I love making these scrapbooks, and I love getting your cards and letters. You know the address. It's everywhere. If you don't put your favorite search engine, Dave Olson postal address, and send it to me, Ryoko, Ryoko, Ichiro, Olson, with two O's, just not consecutive. Fondly.